Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel StartupLanes.com. I am Mohre Tanvi and as you know, these are the series of interviews that we are conducting for the Startup of the Month. In today's interview, we have Mr. Rajat, who has created a B2B network of more than 300 sale points in the infrastructure vertical, generating revenue of more than $20 million per year over last 15 years, giving him extensive experience in managing a retail network of people at the ground level who may not be very educated. He has managed a team of more than 55 professionals providing outsourced remote office services like medical, legal and generating transcription services to various clients in the United States, Canada and Australia, saving valuable time and money. Lastly, he has also managed a team of coders and developers to create a customized software solution and mobile app for his client in the United States and India. In his latest business venture, he has launched his own mobile app called Highlight by SocioRank, a patented secured B2B SaaS solution to help you converse and collaborate with controls to enhance productivity for your remote team across multiple apps and data silos, giving you a unified information management and collaboration platform. So let's jump into the video directly.
Hello, good afternoon, sir. I am Tanvi More from Startup Lanes, and we are very grateful to have you on the board for this interview.
Thank you, Tanvi. It's good to be here.
Sir, I would request you to please introduce yourself to our viewers.
My name is Rajat Singhania. I'm the founder and CVO of Highlight by SocioRank. So Highlight is a patented unified information management and collaboration platform rolled into one.
Sir, so my very first question to you is that how did you come up with this idea of startup?
Okay, so this idea came from a personal pain point. For one of my other businesses, I was attending a conference and some information popped up on my mobile. And I swiped it thinking I'll come back to it next day once I'm back in office. But next day I couldn't find that information. I spent a few hours looking for it, but it was not to be found. And as a result, I lost a good business opportunity. Now, see, on hindsight, there could have been a better way to deal with it. But I am a firm believer that everything happens for a reason.
Yeah.
So obviously, when this happened, it created a thought and I started looking around that is there any other product or solution which can help me manage in such a situation? And I did not find any easy way to do that. Mm-hmm. So then I asked a lot of friends and all that, is anybody else also facing such a challenge or was I the only one who thought this was a problem?
Mm-hmm.
And I got an overwhelming guess that a lot of people face this problem. So that is how the journey started. Creating a product to help people manage information, okay, which pops up out of nowhere and you have no way how to manage it.
Mm-hmm.
So this is how the product came into being.
Okay. So sir, what are the difficulties that you faced in the initial stage of the journey?
Well, the difficulty was all kinds of difficulties because obviously when you're trying to do something new, so there's always a challenge that how do you do it? You know, when there's something established, that's the difference between a startup and a business.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in case of a business, there are certain, everything is decided. You just need to follow a rule book. It's defined. There are SOPs in place. You do that. You know, somebody, 10 other people have done it. You follow that. And there's a very good chance things will work out the way you want them to. Now, when you're doing a startup, every day there's a new challenge. Every day there's a new thing you need to look at.
Sure.
Sometimes your challenge can be your coder who's making the product suddenly decides to go on a leave, mm-hmm, and you have a deadline to roll out the release. So you are not able to do that. Sometimes you're trying to do some technology change. You're trying to give a function, which sounds very easy, but for some reason it takes, you think it will happen in 2 days, but it takes 2 weeks or maybe 2 months or it doesn't happen at all.
Mm-hmm.
So that aspects, lot of things you have to realign to it. So
okay,
then you create a product, you take it to people, and then you realize, oh, people would prefer it working not in X way, but a Y way. So you go back and then again change and tweak things so it works the way people want it. So, you know, every day is interesting. You are learning new things every day, and every day is a challenge, and it's part of the fun. It's something you need to be aware of, that this will be part of the journey if you go into a startup.
Mm-hmm. Sir, as you're talking about challenges, I would like to know that what is the gap that you identified in the market?
So we are living in a digital world which is driven by a lot of data. Now, in the digital world driven by a lot of data, it also means that a lot of information is getting generated. And we all as individual users are flooded with a lot of information. In fact, there have been some interesting studies which say that we as users need barely 3-5% of the data we receive or read on any given day. Now, the challenge is, how do you manage that 3-5%? You know, it's literally like taking out the diamond from the mines or the pearls from the oyster, that, or the needle in the haystack, that from all the information there, which is that piece of information which is valuable to you, and how do you manage that? So that is the huge challenge for all of us today. We all suffer from something known as data overload. Now, how does it affect us? Because, you know, when you have too much information, you tend to become, forget things. And your attention span goes down. You are not always having the entire information on your fingertips to make best possible decisions. All this might sound very familiar because most of us experience it. And these things happen because we are dealing with too much data. Reduce the amount of data input you have and you'll see these things go away. So our product is an initiative in the direction to help people reduce the data they have to deal with and ultimately improve their well-being.
Okay. Sir, I would like to know your business model in detail.
Business model. So we are a B2B SaaS product.
Okay.
So it is a per user, per year cost. So we have three versions of the product. We have a basic free trial version for a limited number of days. And then we have an individual paid version. And then we have a business paid version, which has much more advanced features with admin panel, etc. So the model has been made on the likes of similar products globally. And obviously for Indian market, we have kept it very competitive, very aggressively priced, keeping in mind the value we bring to all our users and consumers.
Okay. Sir, at the initial stages, did your friends and family help you in funding?
Well, I did not really have to ask them for much, but yes, of course, there are a lot of people in friends and family who did fund me at different stages as required. I am not that young, so I've done about different businesses for about 31 years. So I had built up some savings because I have run about half a dozen different businesses. So I've created some savings. So I have used those to create my startup. I'm a bootstrap startup with all my money invested myself.
Okay.
Of course, there's been a lot of help and financial and otherwise from friends, family and other well-wishers, which have helped in the journey. But as of now, we're a bootstrap startup.
Okay, great. So have you ever approached the investors? And if yes, then how did you approach them?
So we have just started. January of this year, we started making our pitch deck, getting our presentations ready. Reason being because, earlier we were in the development stage and I did not want to take an investor at that time and sell really cheap. So I wanted to, take out most of the risk and get the product in place. Now that the product is in place, you've got some initial traction, customers. So now to scale up in a faster way, we are looking to get some investors on board. Obviously, yes, of course, we want to get some monetary help from the investors. But more than the money, we are also looking to get the right investors on board who can open the right doors to help us grow the product.
Okay.
So because, of course, money is a necessity to grow. But besides the money, connecting to the right people
is also necessary.
That is, I would say, more important than the money.
Sir, as you know that we are going through uncertain pandemic since a year, so I would like to know that what are the other factors you see impacting your business in the coming years?
Sure. So in fact, the pandemic has been a very interesting mixed bag for us. So on one hand, it obviously gave us a big blow because we have lost about 14 months where we could not do much. So we lost time, money, and we've taken a hit. But then on the other hand, the pandemic itself has justified and created the need for a product like ours. Because our product is about information management, collaboration, especially with people in a distributed environment, which means working from home, remotely, or different places. So, and also about managing information security. So our product is about all these things, which is why people, when we, all the people we spoke to in the last couple of months, they love the product, they realize its power, its value, and are looking forward to adopt our platform to, you know, make themselves work better, more efficiently, more powerfully in such uncertain times. So yes, in the short term, we have taken a bad hit, but I think in the long term, the pandemic would have worked in our favor because, you know, I think for the IT industry or for what we call digital transformation, I think the pandemic has pushed India 5 years ahead because businesses which were not looking at digital adoption or digital transformation are now adopting it with open arms. They're embracing it much more easily. So, which is a huge plus point for Indian businesses.
Okay. Sir, I would like to know that are you planning to hire fresh talents in your business?
Oh, yes. We are always looking to hire fresh talents. And let me tell you, ever since we started, if I have a fresher coming in versus a seasoned person, I will take the fresher. Because I like to encourage youngsters. So, in fact, I've always had more freshers working in my startup than seasoned people. I always think of it as part of my social responsibility to encourage youngsters to learn. And it also I also end up gaining because I get some fresh thoughts which have not been conditioned to think only on one tangent. Because, you know, youngsters who are fresh or freshers, as you want to call it, they have this unique strength and ability to think on lines which have not been defined yet. So that is where you know, new thoughts and ideas come. And then they have a level of energy which probably people do not have after they've been in working for a couple of years. So for me, that is a very strong reason to work with youngsters or freshers, as you call it.
So what are the traits you are looking in the fresh talents if you hire them?
There are a couple of things we are looking at. We are looking at creative skills. That's always an ongoing need, you know, whether it's to create videos or creative different ways of marketing our product. Because like I said, there's no such thing as a perfect marketing solution, you know. Marketing is all about continuously innovating and trying different things to leave a mark in the mind of your customer. So there's always a scope for doing something different or better in the marketing side. So that's one place we are always looking for fresh talent. So whether it is creating videos or creatives, whether it is doing market surveys, whether it is giving thoughts and feedback on the product usability, and whether it is giving suggestions of what can be done in the future in the product, whether it is comparing with other existing products, on the technical side, even on the coding side, we so many times we use interns because they might come up with some thoughts on something to do on the technical side or something what we are doing. You know, there is a scope for improvement everywhere, always. There is no such thing as the perfect product or solution.
Sir, as you mentioned before that you have been part of many businesses earlier, so I would like to know that according to you, what are the personality traits of a good leader?
Well, there are a lot of traits there. So, you know, I read a quote once, and that's one thing which stuck with me. So you cannot call yourself a good leader till you do not create other leaders.
Okay. Yeah.
So great. I would say that is the most important thing, because till you do not create other leaders, you are just a person sitting at the top. Only when you are able to inspire, guide, and create other leaders, do you really become a true leader.
Okay. Sir, I would like to know that what is the good part and what is the worst part of being a CEO?
Well, the good part is you get to make a lot of decisions. You get to decide everything. You get to be in control. You have a vision. You are able to do what you have visualized. The bad part is, if anything good happens, yes, it's on the team. But if anything bad happens, it's on you, because you are the one. You know, the buck stops you at you. So it's your responsibility to guide the entire team and make sure they do whatever is required to achieve the best possible results. Everything may not work and everything cannot work. Mm-hmm. But when what needs to be done depends on you who are sitting at the top, the CEO.
Sir, describe a time you have to make a tough decision, for example, like budget cuts or organizational restructuring or market withdrawals, etc.
So, well, there have been numerous times we have to make tough decisions, so there was a person who was working with us for a long time. Mm-hmm. And he was not able to give us the optimal results we were looking for. Mm-hmm. It was always a tough call that to what extent do you let him do? Because let me tell you, in my 31 years, I have not fired employees. I think in my 31 years, I would have probably fired 2 people in my entire life. And okay. And that is also because they did something which was almost to the point of being almost criminal activity. Let me put it like this.
Yeah.
So we just decided, rather than getting into any legal complications, we asked them to go. So I do not like to ask people to go normally. Mm-hmm. Because as a leader, it's our responsibility to bring out the best in people. Mm-hmm. Now, everybody may not be the best at everything, but everybody is the best at something. And if we can figure out whose strength is what and what they are best at, that is how we make businesses grow and sustain. So, you know, in my other businesses, I have people who are working with me for 20 plus years, 30 plus years. Mm-hmm. I've had situations where people leave me, go, and they come back within 1 year, and then they never look left or right. Because, there's a comfort which happens because I have a different way of working, maybe compared to different businesses. Mm-hmm. So I believe a lot in delegation. I like to give my people a free hand to do what they want. Mm-hmm. Of course, there has to be some plan, what needs to be done, and we need to do things based on the plan. But then, you have to empower your team by giving them the delegating stuff and letting them do it. Because if you want to micromanage and tell them what to do, that may, you may think that is the best way for you, but is it really the best way for them?
No.
So, and they, you may not have discovered that there could be a better way of doing it, which they would know, which you may not know. Mm-hmm. And every day, all of us end up learning things. I have no shame in admitting that every day from many of my team members, I end up learning things about doing some things which I did not know earlier. So it's a constant learning process. The world evolves. It's all about staying up with the times.
Okay. So you had tough decisions firing the people. So what did you do and what are the results now? Like, what are the methods you applied?
So, obviously we had a lot of conversations that this needs to be done. Please find a way to do it. Mm-hmm. If you're facing any challenges, let us know. So the person tried. One fine day, he himself felt that he was not able to do justice. So he comes and tells me, "Sir, let me go. I don't think I'm adding value to the organization." Mm-hmm. So I said, "Okay, very good. If you think you're not adding value, so what do you want to do to correct it?" So he says, "No, sir, please let me go because I'm wasting your money." Mm-hmm. I said, "Letting you go is the easiest thing. But if you realize you're not doing the right thing, then why can't you correct it? What will you do after this job?" He says, "No, I haven't decided." Okay. I said, "Okay, take 1 week off. Think about it and then you come back and then we talk. If you still want to go, you go. If you can find a way how to make this work, we'll make it work." So, in a nutshell, he came back after 1 week. He said, "Okay, I've thought a way, we can make it work, I'll do that." He tried to do that. Even after 1 month, he himself realized he was not able to do that. So, ultimately, he left. But the thing was, I did not have to make, I wanted to make a decision, but I was not able to make a decision. Mm-hmm. But I gave the person a chance. Ultimately, he made the decision. So, he was going through his own challenges. Okay. Hopefully they're better now, but that was the situation.
Sir, are you looking for any vendors to simplify any part of your business?
Yeah, we are looking for partners and affiliates. Okay. We have onboarded some partners and affiliates because we are a solution who's selling to businesses. Mm-hmm. So we are looking for software solution partners literally globally. So we have some people in the US, UK, Europe, Germany, Dubai, Singapore, and some people in India. So we are adding people regularly. So we are looking for partners literally almost all major cities in the world. But our product doesn't really have a geographical limitation, you know. So if we can, our product can be used by people all over the globe.
Yeah. So lastly, I want to ask you that what are your recent and long-term plans for your startup?
Well, the long-term is easier. Like our vision statement is to generate 2.5 billion man-hours of productive time by 2025. That is our vision. Because that is, you know, there was a study done by Economic Times in 2019, which said that every business is losing 25% of its productive time because the stakeholders are spending that time in saving, searching, organizing, and managing information.
Okay.
Now, that's a great amount of time. And this is not the time loss of your labor or your cheap manpower. This is the time loss of your mid to senior management, your most expensive assets. And our product Highlight is here to help you save a minimum assured 30 minutes per day, which works out to more than 100 hours per person per year, year on year. So if you're looking to save time, we are the best product to help you do that. Not only that, with all the data privacy concerns, if you want your own chat or collaboration platform with the entire data hosted on your cloud server, we have a solution for you.
Okay.
If you're concerned about employees walking away with your data, we have a solution for you. So, you know, so we are trying to give solutions to real life, everyday problems businesses have. You know, shortage of time, people walking away with data to the competitors. How do you make sure your data stays private and does not get into the cloud space, you know, on social media platforms? So all those problems we are solving, which are common problems which impact our businesses. So in the long term, we aim to be the go-to product for everybody for managing the information that matters to them. Everything doesn't matter, but information that matters. And in the short term, we want to connect to people, we want to see what problem they are facing and help them solve it and live a better life. And you know, because our tagline is Highlight is here to make you productive, powerful, and profitable. Is that not what business is all about?
Nice. So lastly, I want to ask you that do you want to say something to your viewers or our viewers? It would be great.
Yeah, sure. So, you know, I would say since the platform is Startup Lanes, which means everybody is a startup. So I think startups are the need for every generation, every country, every economy, because all the change which happens in the world happens because of a startup. Businesses follow a defined regime of just giving you a way to earn money, your livelihood. All the growth we see is because of a startup. Every product we use was created because of a startup. The difference is earlier they were not called startups. Now we have a specific name for them. They are called startups. And it is thanks to the startups that we evolve as people. So, and I'm very happy that various platforms like your platform, the government scheme, all of everybody is doing things to help startups. And as an entrepreneur with so many years, I'm happy to see all the support this community is getting. And encouraging people to come out with more and more innovative solutions, because ultimately it will help us all as consumers as well. So, and I'm trying to do my bit to take care of one problem and prevent you from you know, death by data. So if information is your problem, we are your solution. So we are a Made in India product with patents filed here and patents granted in the US. And I would love to, I end up doing a lot of mentoring talks for people also on multiple platforms. So if anybody wants to connect to me and talk on anything, I would be more than happy to talk to them. It doesn't have to be about Highlight, it could be about anything.
Okay, great. So thank you so much for joining with us. It was a pleasure talking to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Tanvi. Thank you so much.